Hi, I'm Nate, and you're watching Photolearningism. It's been a really long time since we stacked up GIMP with Krita, and I want to do some use cases, and this time, look at how they handle photography, walk through the same picture, soup to nuts, as a raw image, and let's just see how they do. So once again, I'm Nate, this is Photolearningism. Thank you so much for joining in. I do a lot of work on this channel to surface the cheap or free art technologies so that you can know about them and make good use of them. Thanks for being here. So today, I want to kind of harken back to a video I did a good long while ago where I pitted GIMP against Krita, and we looked at it from a couple different ways to easily understand what that's supposed to do. I wanted to do kind of a catch-up version of that to keep pace with the new developments, new ways that things have been improved, and we're gonna do it with the latest releases, the latest stable releases of each. It's gonna be Krita 4.4.3 and GIMP 2.10.24. Okay, so knowing that, I'm gonna frame this around photography in this use case. I'd like to try a couple just to kind of see how they compare on different levels, but for today, photography. All right. You may not know that Krita can be used for photography purposes. I'll walk you through if you haven't seen my videos on how that works, but let's get to it. So starting with GIMP, I'm gonna drag in a NEF file, which is a Nikon raw image format. And the way GIMP is designed is it's using the Linux approach, the open source approach, I guess is a more accurate depiction, in that it depends on third-party loading tools. Darktable is a good option. Raw Therapy is a good option that integrates very nicely with GIMP. My initial gut reaction, and you may have noticed this if you see the original video, is that I was not a fan of that. I grew up on Windows where everything was packaged up. It was a one-stop shop, and that's not really the open source mentality. Very much in open source, it's in a methodology, an approach of somebody's already doing something well, why reinvent it? So there's some really excellent raw loading capabilities within Darktable and Raw Therapy. And by the way, they work independently too. I'll put a card up there in case you're curious, over there, in case you're curious to see more about those. But they also serve as a loader for GIMP, and all you have to do when it fires it up, unless you want to make initial corrections, which you certainly can, I'm just gonna leave it alone. Keep it as default. It will then hand that raw image over into GIMP, and here it is. So, pause. I am going to flip on over to Krita and do a similar operation and drag that in. Now, Krita does offer out-of-the-box raw loading. The loader is not great, though. There are a few adjustments here, and this approach here kind of bothers me in that I can't even really see what I'm working on here. If I drag this over, which, yeah, you have to like click it just right, and then I can carefully grab the pixel on the end of it and drag out this window, and then I can start to get a good sense of what's there. This part is not so good, and this does not scale. The good news is that it will do it natively. The bad news is that this is a little awkward. You do have a couple of quick adjustments here, which can offer some benefit when you're gonna tweak the color management profile. You might do some noise correction coming in and out of the gate. These are things that you can do once you get in the tool, but again, the preloading options, in case you're used to that approach, is there. So I'm gonna click OK, and that will hand it over into Krita. There we go. And just so you can compare the two, you can see that they have parity with each other, that they're loading based on the same color profile. It looks the same. So we're doing good so far. All right, so hopping back to GIMP then. All right, I'm gonna do a typical range of adjustments that I would do with a picture. I'm not gonna go too deep. But just to kind of keep it simple for the use case so you can see what GIMP can offer you here and see that it's actually very comparable in GIMP, Krita, as well. And you can make a choice based on your comfort level if you've had experience with one or the other. All right, so looking at this over here, first thing I like to do is duplicate the layer I'm working with. and then change the mode to an overlay that amplifies all the color within, I think by a scale of 1 if I remember right, because you'll notice how everything got very deep and a little darker almost. It's amplifying all those color values appropriately. So I'm going to take that and then walk the opacity down just a little bit because I want some of the effect but not all of it. This is kind of like an approach of doing curves adjustment, but it's just another way to do it, and I find that this just kind of gives me more bang for the buck, you know, for what I want to get done. So set the overlay mode and opacity down a little bit. Next thing that I will do is add a new layer. Just the default layer is fine. And I like using the approach for vignette as using a gradient. That you will find if you're just starting out using GIMP. This is also buddied up with the bucket fill, and that might be what you see first. So you have to click and hold and then flip that over to gradient. I'm making sure that my primary color is black because I'm encapsulating something, and that my mode is set to radial. All right, so I am going to focus here. I'm going to hold shift and drag out so that it makes it a little thinner, and we have an improvised vignette, which I was able to control spacing and depth. Sometimes the vignette controls don't give you that degree of flexibility, so just drawing up the gradient I find is easier. You can walk back on the opacity if it's too intense, which sometimes it is, because again, we're looking to have the psychological focusing, in this case the flower, and it helps to do that. The last thing that I will do as part of the workflow here is I'm going to take a duplicate of the original layer here, and I'm going to pull that up just on top of the overlay that I did. And I want to flip this down to where there is no saturation. And if you're not familiar with what happens, it turns it gray. Really, it's a power of 1 again, and it's dropping off all the values down to pure gray. That's the scale of saturation. So if we take away all the value, it becomes gray. So now that we've done that, I'm going to do just a quick curves adjustment. To make that a little more dramatic, we're going to pull in and intensify the dark darks, the light lights, not too much because I don't want to have that overexposed look. And then what we do as a final step, what I do as a final step, is I take the mode again for that and make it another overlay. Now the reason I do this, that's a little too dramatic, and then I'm going to back off the opacity. The reason I do that is it will make the part that I am trying to focus on pop. Using the black and white overlay layer actually does that for me. Kind of a contrast adjustment, but it does it all with just a layer, and there's a lot of control doing it this way. So this is my approach. This is how I'm getting it done quickly. You can see the process now in GIMP. All right, so now let's hop into Krita. Again, same starting image. I'm going to repeat these steps, and let's see what happens here. All right, so again, I'm going to start by duplicating what we have. Same idea, gonna flip this to overlay and kind of see how that gets deep, but too deep. I'm gonna back the opacity down. Next thing I'm gonna do is add a paint layer. Krita focuses a lot on illustration, so it calls it a paint layer. That's the general purpose layer. All right, I'm going to hop into the gradient tool over here, and I'm just gonna back off a little bit. My colors, I think, are already set, yep, to black, and my tool options are set to radial. You do have to put this checkbox reverse because I kind of like to work my way from the outside in. Otherwise, it will keep the gradient with in the middle instead of on the outer rim like a vignette would typically do. So click reverse, and then same idea. Click and drag out here, and there we go. And I might back that off again just a little bit because I don't want to leach off so much the color. Again, the idea is to focus in here. All right. And again, last thing, going to duplicate the original layer. And I'm going to take this. And for Krita, the option I'm going for is actually under filter. adjust, and then desaturate, which is, again, what you do when you remove all saturation. So it becomes gray. We're going to do a tool curved adjustment, which is under filter, adjust, and color adjustment curves. And same idea here. It doesn't show you the graph here, which you kind of have to guess a little bit more here what you're doing. And to be fair, in some cases, the graph is not fully indicative of what you're trying to do because it's measuring different things. So, but anyways, so that looks pretty cool, pretty dramatic. I'm happy with that. And then we flip that mode over to overlay. Once again, you'll notice kind of a similar drama happening there. And I'm going to back that off until I get some of my color back. There we go. But we still kind of get that overtone boldness, dark, dark, light, light happening. And I really like that. So that is really the way that it fits together. And again, I'll stack these side by side here so you can see that we ended up with very much the same result here. Two different programs, really able to serve up the same base workflow that I do as a typical general rule. They can both do more advanced things like cloning and correction and things like that. The real kind of the tip of the balance here is actually that GIMP specializes in the raw loading process. That is a big plus in favor of GIMP over Krita, and that Krita offers it to you to load it in just so it's a little easier coming into it, but it doesn't give you the flexibility of doing some maybe initial fine tuning that you may want that could be simpler than doing it heading into the program. So that is the GIMP and Krita look when you're working with photography stacked up as a versus, and hope that's helpful. So once again, this has been Photolearningism. Thank you so much for spending some time with me and learning about how you can get a photo workflow done in either GIMP or Krita. If it was helpful, please give me a thumbs up and let me know. Consider subscribing so you don't miss out on the awesome, awesome things that we're going to be doing on this channel going forward. And leave a comment, ask a question, get involved with the community of learners to be a part of something larger than ourselves. And I'll see you at the next video. Thank you so much.